Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing good. And in case you guys get bored, you can try on this galaxy painting. So what you need is just two small sponges and different colors of paint, like white, red, yellow and blue, and a piece of black paper will do. So I like to start with darker color first. Like the dark blue because I like to feel how it goes, and since the background is dark, so it is safer to start with dark colors. So once I start to get confidence, I will move on to slightly brighter color like red, purple, and then I will follow by the yellow color and then white. So you can have two small sponges because one is for brighter colors and the other one is for darker color. So because by doing this you can create a very clean painting with nice darker area and a very bright lighter area. So you don't want to create a muddy painting, and you want your color to be as vivid as possible and as clean as possible. After that, you can put on the color back and forth. Just make sure that you don't overdo it. If you think it's nice, then you can just leave it and move on to the other area. So when you mix blue and yellow, it will turn out as green. So this is something I always tell my students, don't afraid to try on color mixing experiment, because most of the time you will get something very nice. And this is the best thing in art, so just let the paint do its work. They are very good with this punching technique to create this galaxy sky. So I thought that might be a good idea, and you can maybe just take this time, you can try something different with, let's say, with different combinations of colors. Can just keep on trying different color. Okay, so just keep on doing and keep on doing until you are satisfied. Okay, now I'm creating the star using a small brush with white paints. So if you don't have small brush, you can always use the toothbrush and just make the more diluted white paint. Then you dip the toothbrush into the paint and use the tongs to slide through the brush to stretch out the paint on the painting. So both are creating the star, but the effect is slightly different. So it's fine and just depends on your own preference. You can create your own starry sky. So right now I'm using the small brush to draw out the shapes of all the three. So I just draw one by one. Looking up to the sky. And just because I wanted the tree to look super nice, it's green color and looks vivid. So I used the white color paint to paint out the trees. So because white color base can brighten up the color. So you can try on different types of tree, it's totally fine. Just make it simple and easy because you don't want to stress out yourself, and I think you should relax and enjoy when you are doing painting. Okay, so now let's color the tree. So I wanted to make the tree to have the light and shadow areas, so I used yellow and blue to create green. So for the light green, I mix with more yellow, and for the dark areas, like the dark green, I mix with more blue. So I paint it with light green first and then followed by dark green. And I decided the light source will be at the center. So the left side of the tree will be darker than the right side of the tree. Thank you. So for this side, the left side will be brighter and the right side will be darker. So I'm trying to make the bottom three darker and then fine tune the painting. Then you are done and you can do your own decoration, which my student loved the most. Remember, be creative and enjoy what you are doing. See you guys, bye!